Hello and welcome, gorgeous Aries. Welcome to your mid-month reading. I hope everyone's doing really well. Let's get straight into it and see what Spirit would like to bring through these cards. So, of course, take what resonates from the reading and leave what doesn't resonate. Be sure to check in with your own intuition to see which messages resonate for you and which ones you can leave behind. Okay, this one here is your first card, and it is the rose symbol. And the rose is romance is in the air. So of course you will know if that's happening at the moment. You may have met someone new, or you may be getting on track with your current relationship. More romance, more intimacy, more closeness is definitely on the agenda at the moment for you. And the key, successful outcome to your problem. So if you have a problem that's been on your mind, you actually hold the key to open this door that seems to be locked, that seems to be shut. A door shut before you, an opportunity lost. Well, actually, you hold the key and you're going to have Spirit's help to unlock this door. So stay open to synchronicities and stay open to things, messages from Spirit, because there's going to be a successful outcome to the issue or the problem that you have been worried about. The owl, good advice from a wise person. Someone is going to give you really good advice, and it would do you well if you listen to this advice and not just brush it aside, because that may be the tendency, that might be what you're feeling. And we have wealth, so money coming in, abundance, wealth. There's a beautiful energy here for that to come in over the next couple of weeks for you. And the candle, you will be shown the way. Exactly what I was feeling with the key energy, the key symbol. You will have help from Spirit. A miraculous sign from Spirit, from heaven, is going to come your way. It's going to come in a synchronicity. It's going to come in a way that you're not expecting, but you will receive the guidance that you need to clear the way forward in this situation. So of course, place this energy in your life where it fits. And let's take a look at this deck for you, Aries. Guidance for Aries, please, Spirit. This one here. And as the card of perform, every act as if it were your last. Okay, so this is about paying particular attention to your actions. This is about you having to be a certain way with someone. And it seems to me like a performance. You're having to put on a fakeness or a performance. So that might come to light, why that is happening or the underlying energies there. All the spiritual masters tell us to make every decision and choice as if our whole life could be changed because of it. Today, be mindful only of who you are in each and every action. So being very cautious about, cautious and aware, conscious really is the word, being very conscious of your actions. But there's also this underlying energy of you having to perform or put on some kind of fakeness for someone. So that may also come to light. And your second card from this deck is the divine dwells within you and desires that you heal. So there's a hurt, maybe physically, maybe emotionally or psychologically. You'll know where this hurt is, but there is a hurt Spirit is going to bring into your consciousness even more to heal, though. It's for healing. Are you fully aware of that presence? Call upon the power of the divine to awaken its healing force within you. Be grateful for this miracle. So a beautiful miracle will happen, and it's in alignment with healing. And this will happen over the next couple of weeks up until the end of the month. Guidance for Aries, please, Spirit. Angels and guides, bring through a message for Aries, please. This one here is yours. Yes. Okay. So insights that come from meditation, the need to take a vacation, allow yourself more time before making a decision, mental exhaustion, and get more sleep. So making sure that your sleep habits are healthy. And this is about downtime, taking time away from any drama, and limiting communication. So that might be your choice, or someone may be limiting communication with you, but it's about you centering yourself and you having a presence, a strong presence internally over the next couple of weeks. And the Queen of Swords, brilliant, experienced, humorous, judgmental, releasing situations or people that no longer serve you. It's time to cut these people out. It's time to remove yourself from this drama. Seeing the humor in difficult situations as well is going to be of benefit to you. Focusing on career, divorced or unmarried individuals, and that may resonate for you as well. So let's take a look at this little deck here. Guidance for Aries, please, spirits. Okay, this one here is yours. And it's the Hive. Industry, you work hard. Your dedication will pay off, but you may have to start alone. Abundance, honey equals money. And you did have the Wealth card here, so there's definitely some sort of wealth or financial or material wealth and abundance coming your way. Success in business, the Queen and her worker drones. Isn't this interesting? You're coming up as the Queen here. So we have the Queen. You're being represented by this energy. So you're, it looks like you're in charge. Or you will have to step up and take some kind of leadership. And place of healing, curative balm, regenerative, antiseptic. You are rebuilding, and the Tower. So rebuilding a strength, which is a Tower. A place of healing. And this, of course, goes very well with this card here, speaking of healing. So that's the symbol of the Hive for you over the next couple of weeks. And your second card from this deck is Branches. Spiritual choice. All paths lead to one destination. There is never one correct answer. Reaching for enlightenment. Strive for growth, clarity, acceptance, wisdom, and purpose. And spiritual awareness, enlightenment. Remain grounded as you explore spirit and the tree of life. So I feel that this card here, it speaks of this meditation insights coming through. Okay, and also stay open to different answers coming through from spirit than what you're expecting. All right, let's take a look at this deck. Guidance for Aries, please, spirit, angels and guides. Let's take a look at this deck for Aries, please. Okay, this one here is yours. Okay, it looks like a cup card here, the Four of Cups, which is interesting because we have another four here. So there is stability that's going to come into your life in some way over the next couple of weeks. Mentally, psychologically, there's a calmness, but also emotionally as well. Now, you can see here on this image that you're actually looking at another jar here. There is a jar that is broken over here, so you might be distracted by doing more menial things perhaps, or your attention is elsewhere, but it's about staying open to the bigger picture or perspective so you can see what's going on behind you. And we have the Two of Wands, and this is a partnership card. So Spirit is saying there's a partnership, there's a union, a togetherness that you have with someone. You know, we do have the Rose card here as well. So it may in fact be that it's romance for you, but it doesn't have to be. It might be business related or a friendship. Looks like you both are trying to create. You have similar goals. You have similar outlook. And you're trying to manifest or create here in your life in a powerful way. But it's also interesting that this card here is touching on the perfect, acting perfect. So this energy might be touching on the relationship where you're having to be fake or having to be perfect, or you're having to perform, feel like you're having to be perfect or having to perform or be fake in some way. And the Seven of Wands. So there's a bit of a battle that you're up against, that's for sure. You have a barrier, a protective barrier here, and you're trying to defend your position. So stay strong and stand up for what you want. And the Seven of Cups. So this is this can mean that there's a lot of choices and you're not sure about which one to make because of emotions. So it's about staying as grounded as you can. And the Six of Cups, this is speaking of the past. I mean, this kind of looks like the Wheel as well. So this is about a past issue, relationship, or person that's going to come to mind or come into your life again. And this also speaks of children and the inner child. So you might be working with the inner child, or a child maybe important in your life over the next couple of weeks. And the Five of Cups. So a loss or a disappointment. There's grief with this card as well. It is linked in by the looks of it to the past in some way. So it's about making a new choice emotionally, from what I can see here. It's about making a new choice for you and how you, well, what you want to create really in your life in the future. And so that's a powerful energy. Remember, you hold the key, Aries. You hold the key here. Even though it seems like your door's closed or there's something that's ending, you hold the key. And Spirit will help you with that as well, of course. So stay open to those signs and those messages. So let's take a look now at the pendulum. So if you have a specific question you would like to ask Spirit through the pendulum, then you can think of that question now. And that's a yes. So of course, check in with your intuition. See how that answer resonates with your question. It's been a pleasure to read for you today, Aries. I hope Spirit's come through clearly for you. Take care, stay blessed, and I'll talk to you again soon. Bye for now.